Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm the new school teacher.
Your hair is pretty long.
I'm letting it grow till the war's over.
It's liable to reach your ass, son.
Let's hope not. Which way is the school, mister?
If you're here to teach, I reckon you can read.
Baby's breath.
Right, baby's breath. This one? Queen Anne's lace.
Queen Anne's lace.
When Gardens Only had their towers and all the garrisons were flowers, when roses only arms might bear, and men did rosy garlands wear, that means they were all flower children. They had time to write pretty words like that.
Who wrote that one down, Conrad?
Ladies and gentlemen, I don't mean to take you away from your daily routine. I know you got stores to open, clothes to wash, marketing to do, and other chores. But I've just lost my job and I want to talk. My name's Pat Conroy. I was paid $510 a month to teach a bunch of kids on a little island off this coast how to read and write. I also try to teach them to embrace life openly, to reflect upon its mysteries, and to reject its cruelties.
Get out of here before I knock every freckle off your face.
That's mean. Wasn't that great?
Come on, Jocko. You got to win by two baskets.
He said one.
I changed my mind. Let's go.
Now, you're not going to cheat the boy out of his victory. Come on, be a good sport.
Who the hell asked you anything?
Don't you talk to me like that. No, you won't. Now, he beat you, and it was beautiful.
Lily, you better get in the house before I kick your butt.
It was just beautiful.
No, I mean it. Come on, let's go. Hurry, come on.
Just touch that ball. Dad.
You better move, woman.
All right.
You disobeyed a direct order, Hawk. A direct order from your commanding officer.
Yes, sir.
You knew you'd catch hell for it.
Yes, sir.
You went ahead and did it anyway. I want to know why.
Yes, I thought... I promised Arabelle and I thought Toomer might be in trouble.
And what?
And because I was your son.
What the hell's that got to do with it?
Because you would have done it.
We're talking about you!
Oh, sure! And I'm a Meacham. A Meacham's a thoroughbred and winner all the way. He two snails while the other kids eat cotton candy. He never surrenders. He never gives up.
You disobeyed a direct order!
Get your knees up this high, boy!
Why don't you just get the hell out of here and make it easier on everybody?
Don't worry about me, sir!
Dumbass.
They won't run me out, sir!
Well, if they try, I want to know about it.
Sir?
You come to me, just me. You understand? If anything happens, anything weird, anything at all, you tell me. This is gonna be the last time we talk. So if you got something you wanna say, leave a note for me in the library. In a book called The Decline of the West by Oswald Spengler. Hadn't been checked out in the history of the Institute. Now get down and give me some push-ups and press the white trash.
Gentlemen of the fourth year, be seated. Tonight, it is my privilege to welcome you to the Brotherhood of the Ring, the Fellowship of the Line. The ring is a sacred symbol of the Institute and its ideals.
I grew up slowly beside the tides and marshes of a Carolina sea island. We lived in a small white house, won by my great-great-grandfather, Winston Shadrach Wingle.
I saw you at the Charleston Music Festival last summer with Brahms Violin Concerto.
Bartok.
Have you ever seen a Stradivarius up close, Tom? This is the finest instrument ever made. Everyone, I'm going to play something in Mr. Wingo's honor. It's not that often we have southern guests, eh?
So I returned to my southern home and my southern life. And it is in the presence of my wife and children that I acknowledge my life, my destiny. I am a teacher, a coach, and a well-loved man. And it is more than enough. In New York, I learned that I needed to love my mother and father and all their flawed, outrageous humanity. And in families, there are no crimes beyond forgiveness. But it is the mystery of life that sustains me now. And I look to the north. And I wish again that there were two lives apportioned to every man and every woman. At the end of every day, I drive through the city of Charleston. And as I cross the bridge that'll take me home, I feel the words building inside me. I can't stop them or tell you why, Sam. But as I reach the top of the bridge, these words come to me in a whisper. I say them as prayer, as regret, as praise. I say, Lowenstein. Lowenstein.